From the AGT Center in Rosetown, Saskatchewan, 60 minutes west of Saskatoon is where you'll find us tonight, where the Stoney Creek Generals are looking for their first ever Allen Cup Championship. Meanwhile, across the hall, this storied franchise has been here 8 of the last 10 seasons. The Generals and Generals are set to hook up tonight in a special province of Saskatchewan. They play in communities across our great nation. They play to be part of something bigger than themselves. They very simply play for the love of this great game. Nowhere is this love better demonstrated than in one of the oldest national championships. The fabric of hockey runs through Saskatchewan. The 2018 Allen Cup is next. Provinces of Alberta and Ontario well represented here tonight. It's Generals versus Generals from Central Saskatchewan. What a week it's been. The round robin began on Monday, and these players now stepping onto the ice, hoping to win a national championship tonight. Number 97 in 2018 is a player that we will keep a very keen eye on here tonight. Welcome inside, Brian Munns alongside Dave Tomlinson. Dave, boy, we saw some exciting semifinal play last night. We've been keeping an eye on this tournament all week long. It has been a battle all the way through, not only for these two teams that are playing this evening, but from everybody that started at the beginning of the week.
Well, even in the round robin, the first six games, four of them were ties. I mean, some of these teams have played a lot of hockey. And so in this final here, you've got the Lacombe Generals, who were built to play in finals in Allen Cups. They won it in 2016. They lost in 2017. And then you've got Stoney Creek, who surprised everybody to get here. And they're going to see if they can take down the Masters here in this matchup of Generals.
Well, how close it's been. Let's take a look at the standings from round robin play. And you talked to both coaches coming into the game here tonight. There hasn't been one team that they thought that they would have an opportunity to take lightly. And then as everybody fast forwarded into a do or die situation, both games were separated by only a 3-goal performance. Stoney Creek able to outlast the Southeast Prairie Thunder by a final score of 5-2. David Brown was brilliant in goal in a 35 save performance, while Lacombe able to knock off the Hawks by a 4-1 margin as well. That game a little bit sooner to be decided. And because the Generals were able to win that game so early, they had a pretty impressive performance from the blue line, didn't they?
Well, they did. And one of the players to focus on is a shifty defenseman, number 8 for the Lacombe Generals, Nathan Deck. What I like about him is he can really handle the puck. A savvy defender, youngster, but tell you what, he won it in 2016. Then he went over to Finland. He played with Mora. He got that team elevated in the top league, and he's back here again. Had a nice power play goal last game. Special teams have been doing pretty well for Lacombe throughout this tournament.
How about for Stoney Creek and maybe one of their talented skills players that'll try and light the lamp tonight?
Well, if you want to talk about lacrosse style goals, I think he innovated that in the skills competition in the OHL. This is Rob Heise, and I'll tell you, he can do anything he wants with the puck. He had a 5-point night in the Robertson Cup final to win that series for them to get here. And since he's been here, he's done nothing but just electrify the crowd with some of his moves. Now, this Lacombe team's pretty physical, so if they can take him out with their physical play, they negate one of the better players for Stoney Creek.
Speaking of the crowd, it's been a jam-packed building all week long, and we'll look forward to the final game here tonight. A battle of Generals. Stoney Creek and Lacombe are set to go here tonight in Saskatchewan. Enjoy it. The Allen Cup is next here on TSN.
The 2018 Allen Cup from Rosetown, Saskatchewan is brought to you by Esso. The Esso brand has fueled Canada's love of hockey for over 30 years. By Nike, official gear of Canada's national hockey team. By RBC, let's make Sunday happen. And by TELUS, powering the network that keeps us all connected.
The Grand Falls-Windsor Cataracts are the defending champions, and here tonight, a new champion set to be crowned inside the AGT Center, one of the great historic hockey buildings here on the prairies, as we take you behind the starting goaltender and take a look at 33-year-old David Brown, who's playing for his hometown Stony Creek Generals tonight. He's logged every minute of ice so far, and Brian Hamm says he will be a big key in tonight's game. At the other end of the ice, he was a Philadelphia Flyer draft pick back in 2008. Jacob Desaris has played just once during regulation time. He and his goaltending partner, Steven Stanford, have been 1A, 1B all season long. And tonight, the 27-year-old from Calgary will try and backstop his club to the fourth Allen Cup championship in franchise history. The referees for tonight's game are Jason Bourdon and Bryce Sebastian. On the lines, it's Ryan Lundquist and Riley Fitzsimmons. Generals are in the blue. That would be the Stony Creek Generals here tonight. They look like the New York Rangers, and they've got position at center ice now. And here comes Hissey near side, a quick shot, and Desaires will glove it down just 18 seconds in.
They're going to count on Desaires to make some of those solid saves. That's an easy stand-up glove save for him early. And talk about coaching. This is the coach of the Stony Creek Generals, Brian Hamm. He said he's been here three times as a player. He's won it once. That was back in 2008. See if he can take some of that winning mojo and put it amongst his team.
Generals able to take it off the draw. Lacombe feeding it in. Velcourt working it in. There's Heisman down to Velcourt in the right wing corner. Jesse Todd parked in front, number 97. We showed you him in the opening, and there'll be a lot tonight of the big man trying to find it here in front of his bench. The rolling puck comes free, and Nick Cazulino will work it deep inside the Lacombe zone. Big hit, first one of the night here. Cazulino at center ice, plays it right side, but Fergus was just a step ahead of the play, and Brennan Evans will rub him out for some good measure.
Well, I'm talking about a detailed coach. That's Sean Robertson, and talking with him yesterday before the semifinal game, he was focused, and they kept their same game day routine here. Lacombe came in at the same time as did the last game and tried to just replicate everything. Again, they lost last year, won in 2016, and they're looking to get back to hoisting that trophy.
Martin Lee will fire it long distance in on goal, and Desiris will glove it down. Deck playing it off the wall. Lacombe in front of their bench. Ricks will deal it all the way in. This will be an icing call again here against Lacombe, and the linesmen are testing out their whistles early here anyway.
Well, one of the things in this tournament, there will be some icings because the players can change. The coaches can use that as a strategy. If you get tired, just bang it down the ice, get some fresh legs out there, unlike in the NHL where you have to stay out there. And of course, no trapezoids. The goaltenders can wander, and they have been doing that in this tournament.
Fergus gets it off the draw for Stony Creek down and behind the goal, now setting up and behind his net. Play it up long, aerial feed comes out ahead to Miles Bell. He'll chip it towards David Brown, and this time he will hold on to a bit of a ping pong affair here tonight.
Well, Miles Bell's name came up when we were talking to the coach, Sean Robertson, saying that he's about to break through. They want their power play to be an important piece. Lacombe does. They feel that if they can draw some penalties, that's the way they can take down the Stony Creek Generals this evening.
Deck able to hold it in off the faceoff. There's Bell that you just mentioned, pointless so far in the tournament. Deck retreating back in his own zone. He and his defense partner Doug Jesse will have a lot of ice here for Lacombe as they vie for the fifth Allen Cup championship for the province of Alberta here tonight. Gengalski lost control in his own end. Stebner going for it here in front of the Stony Creek bench. Now it's stolen away. Centering attempt. First best scoring chance of the night, and Travis Granbois gets turned away by David Brown. Dalrymple rattles it off the high glass. Stebner in behind the goal now for Granbois. Looking for Dalrymple, top of the circle. Banks it off a skate. Came dangerously out in front. And Stony Creek's Matthew Bragg will deal it all the way down the ice. Matthew Bragg, what a Allen Cup championship last year with the Grands Falls Windsor Cataracts. Playing for a new squad, trying to go back to back. The only player this week that has a chance to do it. Barteau holds it in here for Lacombe. A sharp angled shot, and Brown will squeeze it tight along the left post.
Last game for the Stony Creek Generals, they did not allow a lot of odd man rushes, but one gets created right here. Just can't get the puck to the neutral zone. A bit of a stick lift and across, but the nice pad save. It's a right pad by David Brown, and again, he has been the backstop for them throughout this tournament.
Gannon wins the faceoff back to the blue line.
Shot through Amaze, goes back and behind the goal. Backhanded by Blanchard, comes over to Pageau. Evans retreating back for it there. Smith will get ahead of him. Smith's backhand on net to Saris the save. Back come Lacombe, 3-on-3 now, joining in on the attack. It's a 4-on-3 for the trailer. Ian Bartow scores! The 29-year-old, 2 minutes and 45 seconds in, has given the Lacombe Generals a 1-0 lead.
Odd man rush is capitalized. Bartow finds his spot over the blocker. After a chance up ice by the Generals, their forwards get caught. It's a 3-on-3, but Bartow realizes and joins. Here he is in your screen, and he'll get it just past the blocker of a somewhat screened David Brown. So Lacombe opens the scoring. Bartow had a goal last game, falls it up with the opener. The Fort Saskatchewan native has got Lacombe up 1-0.
Early shots on goal are 4-3 in favor of Lacombe. Deck from center ice will raise it in high. We'll have to get a shot of that glass at some point. It's literally two panes high, protecting the end fans along the end wall. Another chance there on the doorstep for Colin Belcourt. Didn't work out. Taken here by Martin Lee. Gets pressured by Belcourt. Hoistman comes in after it as well. Now Fergus will navigate his way. This should be icing as it goes down. They'll elect to wave it off and play will continue. Belcourt gets by DaCosta. Heisman's shot goes wide. Belcourt quickly in on the rebound. Looking for Jesse Todd. He's got it near wing side. Todd back to the midpoint. Dalrymple put it off the crossbar. Walking in, Miles Bell, and he didn't miss that one by much. Lacombe has come out flying here tonight.
Well, they've certainly raised their game. The Stoney Creek Generals in the semifinal played Assipetot in the First Nations in New Brunswick, and the pace wasn't quite like this.
Well, Justin DaCosta wanted to slow it down and behind the goal and got it as far as center ice before it's worked right back in there by Dylan Nowakowski. Bartow able to hold it in. Our first period goal scorer here early in the 2018 Allen Cup from Rosetown, Saskatchewan. Evans just inside his own line. He'll feed it too far. A diving Dennis Ricks can't get his stick on it. Look at Bartow from the point position, working down and behind the net. That left the far side open here, which allows Stoney Creek to move to center ice. Dingalski got it rink wide. To Zolino and Barkowski will wrap at each other's ankles away from the puck. To Zolino will chip it there. Donati gets away from the check of Brennan Evans. And 5 minutes into the frame here, Lacombe will look to add to their lead. Deck shot goes off a stick. Played there by Scott Hotham. To Zolino out to center ice. Good pace to this one early on. Deck, the former Prince Albert Raider, will deal it deep into the corner. Martin Lee being watched by Tegan Moore. In behind his goal now, Scott Hatham will get it. Hatham's second attempt out to the red line, off the stick of Bragg. Comes in. Scoring chance here for Rob Heasy. And he just ran out of room as he was angled out perfectly defensively.
And you have to play the man with a player like that. He's been getting some good scoring opportunities throughout, but they're just guided into the end boards and wasn't able to make that toe dragon shot that he wanted to. Here's the chance earlier from Dalrymple off the blocker again. Some traffic in front. And the Lacombe Generals just coming at Stoney Creek in waves.
Shots are a 2-1 margin right now, favoring Lacombe at 6-3. Gannon chasing it after it here quickly. Desmond Marshall also working on the forecheck right now for these sand-colored Lacombe Generals. Justin DaCosta over to his defense partner, Darren Cousins. Cousins will work it in. Smith in after the puck now, worked it along the sidewall. Taken freely here by Dalrymple. Towards the blue line area it comes out. Pageau will feed it back there to the captain, and Blanchard will sauce it out to center ice here for Smith. Matt Smith and Tuzzolino playing catch with it. Now Krunkle's shot right on goal. And Jared Krunkle gets turned away by Jacob DeSaris. 1-0. Ian Bartow has given the Lacombe Generals the lead here in Rosetown. It's been a great week of hockey so far, and here we are tonight inside the AGT Center, just over an hour outside of Saskatoon, and what a beautiful town model, the heart of the Wheat Belt. Close-knit community here, and it's produced a lot of sports legends, not only here in the province of Saskatchewan, but outside of the game of hockey. Some of curling's greats have been here. This is where they call home. Sherry Madaw, the four-time bronze medalist. And someone you're very familiar with as well,
yes,
Mr. Tomlinson.
Rob Friend, who grew up here in Rosetown, played hockey in his backyard and soccer as well. Soccer took over. They called him the Canadian Tower. 10 years in the national program, 7 years in the Bundesliga, and won an MLS Cup a couple years ago with the LA Galaxy, and then retired back to Vancouver, my area.
Hockey royalty learned how to play the game as well. We'll tell you more about the McCrimmons as the night continues on. Here's another scoring opportunity. Lacombe unable to get a shot away, though, as Heisman's as he fanned on the 3-on-1 attempt. Did that puck stay in? Yes, it did. Bartow able to just hold it in by a millimeter. Battling in the corner now. Heisman's gets held up by Blanchard. Comes to the line. Evans shot. Missed glove side. On the right wing side, here's Bartow in behind the goal, wrap around, pad save, the jam away. David Brown's able to freeze it with bodies all over his crease.
Lacombe just continues to control play in the offensive zone, and Stoney Creek's trying to back off a little bit, but it's the speed and the wraparound here. David Brown gets across the pad just inside, but the puck does not go over the line. As we see another jam chance, that's Bartow, who scored the opening goal, and he is coming in from the blue line. Bit of a tough customer to handle.
Jesse off the faceoff, right into the glove again, and Brown will freeze that. David Brown started his career playing 4 years in the Central Hockey League, moved on to 4 years in the American League, bounced around to 7 different teams, and then went on to a stellar career at the University of Notre Dame.
Yeah, he won the best goalie back in 2007, and they won the CCHA as well. We've got our first penalty of the hockey game.
It's going to be a hooking minor. And it looks like down a goal, Stoney Creek will get the first power play of the night. Dylan Nowakowski will take a seat.
Yeah, and you can see just the reaching in there as Stoney Creek was looking to get the puck in deep. Penalties where if you keep your feet moving a little bit more, you can catch up. So door opens a little bit for Stoney Creek on the power play.
Stoney Creek has 3 power play goals in the event so far. Looking to tie, but breaking the puck out on the far side shorthanded is Travis Granbois. Justin Donati will leave it there, and Nick Tuzzolino will give it back here to Donati. Crosses at center ice and across the home line. Taken down by Moore, who lost everything. And I think Tegan Moore will take another penalty here. And Stoney Creek will have a 5-on-3 power play and a big-time chance to tie the game.
Another stick infraction. They're calling this one a trip. Some speed. And then you can see at the last moment there, just into the skates. So this is going to be a tricky opportunity here. For Deceres, the goaltender, Tegan Moore sits. Thompson, Manitoba. It's pointless so far through the tourney.
Hissey, Gondolski, and Donati are up front on the power play. Tyler Donati, the brother, will feed it there to Rob Hissey. Hissey back door. The chance didn't work out there as Deceres is able to get his pad on it. Donati into the left corner. Sharp angled shot. And Justin Donati missed it. Big time pressure, big collision in front as Bartow will run over Igor Gondolski. Top of the left wing circle, shot didn't get through. Held in again by Tyler Donati. Bottom of the faceoff circle for Rob Heise. Scores! What a passing play, the 5-on-3. They're able to tie the game. And a 5-on-4 power play will continue.
That's three games in a row that Justin Donati has been able to beat a goaltender. You've got Heise, who's off the post. He's the passer. There's a shot block. It gets back to the point. Worked on down. It's just a little saucer pass here. It didn't work earlier. It works right there. Justin Donati is able to get the puck past the blocker before DeSaris gets over, and we've got a tie score.
Second power play goal of the week for the 31-year-old out of Oakville, Ontario, Justin Donati. Power play remains right now for Stoney Creek. They've been able to equalize the game. We'll look to go ahead now for the first time tonight. 70 seconds remaining in the power play. Blanchard's going to skate back into his own goal. Brown will set it up. Went along to the right side here, and Chris Hewlett. Blanchard looking for an outlet. Being watched there by Gannon. Blanchard will stride it now here on the right side to Fergus. Blanchard, far side pass now, and Conkle stood up by Dalrymple. Deck behind his goal on the penalty kill. Played it for Desmond. Into the skates. Deck will feed it out to center ice. Blanchard goes cross ice. And Hewlett will put it right onto the tape here at Fergus. Less than half a minute remaining in the power play. Stoney Creek able to capitalize and tie the game.
Well, they're more comfortable. This is their fourth power play marker of the tournament. And the way that Lacombe is coming after them early in the game, this can turn things into their favor. They're handling the puck more. They're able to set the pace a little bit better.
Nathan Peugeot couldn't find it at center, and they're going to bring a faceoff here as the Stoney Creek Generals ice the puck on the power play.
In this tournament, so many games and so little time, if you don't get that bye. And for Stoney Creek, this will be the fourth game in four nights. Again, their semifinal to get here. They're able to get past the opposition, Assipatog. They really just racked up shots and wore them down.
DaCosta gives it to O'Mara. Broken up at the blue line. Tegan Moore ready to come out of the penalty box. He is free. So the Stoney Creek Generals are now 1-for-2 on the power play as we just passed the midway point of the opening period. Brandon Evans off the boards now. Nowakowski to center ice. Belcourt takes a check there from Hissey. Here's a steal now. Lacombe, Belcourt rattles it high off the end glass. And they're going to blow it down, saying it went too high as it hit that second pane back in behind David Brown.
It's just the wrong time to turn the puck over. You have things going your way with some pressure. But instead, it's a to look up the middle. It doesn't reach its intended target. Don't want to be doing that to Lacombe all night.
Right off the faceoff, another shot, and Brown is able to grab it. How about this, back in behind David Brown? I haven't seen this before, I'll be honest with you, but it's pretty cool.
It is, two levels of glass. Forget wiring or netting. Brown certainly comfortable.
And there is that black line, you can see it, regulation height. So if it does hit the second pane on top, whistle will be blown by the officials. We've had that happen once already this evening, but much better opportunity for the fans to see what's going on in front of them instead of looking through that netting. Greg Dalrymple will leave the puck for Brad Stebner. Right side now, and Colin Belcourt. Belcourt takes a check from Scott Hotham. Hotham turns it around the wall. Played here to Gondolski. Stopped at center ice, Heismans. Leaves it for Deck, quick pass back up ahead to Belcourt. 2-on-5 right now. The Lacombe Generals will deal it in. Hard collision there. Off the side of the net, trying to tuck it in from a sharp angle is Dennis Ricks, who's still looking for his first point of the week. Ricks with another low shot. Didn't get it through. Played by Scott Hotham around the wall. Over to Chris Hewlett. Bouncing puck from the line. Kept in there by Miles Bell. Dennis Ricks in behind the goal. Held up. Martin Lee working with it. Here's Lacombe. Nathan Deck into the corner. Walking out in front. Ricks is shot. And Brown's able to get a piece of it. Kept in at the line. Another shot. And Brown will freeze it. With just over 8 minutes remaining here in a 1-1 draw.
Well, Lacombe's the more physical team. They've been that way through the tournament. And Stoney Creek is kind of surviving here in the middle part of this first period. But they've been relying on their goaltender, Brown. And he's come up big for them to get them here.
Lacombe wins the faceoff. Deck held it in. High rising shot goes wide of the goal in the left wing corner. Now it's tied up. Play deep in there for Gannon. Marshall trying to help out as well. Blanchard will fall down. Jesse skating over after it. Takes a check there from Tuzzolino. Jesse along the perimeter plays it. Marshall trying to sidestep his check in there. Has Desmond out in front. Puck comes to him and it jumped over his stick right when he wanted to shoot. Jesse skating back here with Drag right behind him.
Harden seeing more turnovers by the defense for Stoney Creek. That was their strength in their game against the Southeast Prairie Thunder in the semifinals to get here, but just the pressure and the physical play by Lacombe is forcing them to get the puck up quicker than they want.
Under 7.5 minutes remaining in the first period, and the Lacombe Generals will be called here for icing. And we'll have a faceoff coming up to the left side of goaltender Jacob DeSaris.
Well, DeSaris, as you mentioned, alternates. And so he gets this start in the finals, a 28-year-old from Calgary, Alberta. For the Seattle Thunderbirds, Brandon Wheat Kings, who won a championship, Memorial Cup 2011 with the St. John Sea Dogs.
A lot of depth here with this Lacombe team. Used to be called the Bentley Generals. They've moved into Lacombe. Three-time Allen Cup champions of 2009, 13, and 16. They struck first, but have given up the equalizer on a 5-on-3 power play against DaCosta. Over now to Cousins. Cousins will play it up in front of his teammates, and crossing out at center ice now is Matt Smith. All by his lonesome, sends it right into the logo. And Jacob DeSaris will hold on to it. Shots on goal right now are 12-7. In favor of the Lacombe Generals, we're tied at one. As we continue the Allen Cup here tonight in Rosetown, Saskatchewan, 2 hours away, my hometown of Humboldt, Saskatchewan, and we know the story, the tragedy that occurred last Friday night. Everybody in the hockey community keeping the Broncos in our thoughts and prayers to the families affected, to those that have lost their sons and daughters, to the coaching staff who lost a dad and a husband. We continue to grieve with you here on the prairies here tonight during the Allen Cup. And Hockey Canada announcing today as well that Humboldt Strong, which you saw in front of the benches, will be on the boards of all Hockey Canada events as we continue here in the seasons of champions. Stoney Creek's Tyler Donati sends it towards the goal. 1-1 here in the opening frame. Gengulski back towards the line. Blanchard's shot didn't get through, and Lacombe will come back the other way. 4-on-3. Belcourt to the line, looking to drop it off. Barteau will put on the brakes. Belcourt from a sharp angle. That goes off of Todd, and it deflects on the doorstep. In a play and into the stands.
You can see how quick Lacombe is able to get the puck up the ice and towards the goaltender. 12 shots now for Lacombe. And David Brown's evening is going to remain busy.
Fergus will take the faceoff here, wins it for the Stoney Creek Generals, who are deemed the visiting squad here tonight. Cam Fergus had to go off a leg as he'll battle for it down. Working along the left wing side, it's Hewlett. Chance trying to take the lead, they do! On the doorstep, the assistant captain able to find it and meet DeSaris low to the stick side. And for the first time this evening, Jarrett Conkle has given Stoney Creek the lead.
Nifty hands in front. The forecheck putting it behind the net, and then this puck is going to get cycled down into the corner. The Donati brothers working, and just a misstep in front. The nice hands, and Conkle counts one. 2-1 now for Stoney Creek. 5-year each CHLer, and Conkle playing all over, but this is his third season with Stoney Creek, and he's put them up 2-1.
He's been the setup man until the championship game here tonight with a team-high 4 assists, but he's able to score his second this week right now to give his Stoney Creek teammates the 2-1 lead. Despite the fact right now they're being outshot 12-9, They weathered the storm early, and I think that might be the key. In the first 5 minutes, Lacombe was a better squad. They were all over David Brown, but those blue-clad Stoney Creek team has really been able to kind of take the momentum back here right now.
Well, I felt that 5-on-3, they're able to kind of move the puck around like they wanted to. Their top players convert for a goal, and they're able to hold off Lacombe for the most part, and managed to... Nice forecheck creates a loose puck, and it's put in the back of the net.
Keenan Nesbitt works the puck in the far right wing corner. The Alberta champions can't keep it, though. Marshall will help out. Left wing side comes off the wall. O'Mara playing it now. Rob Heise takes it away from pressure, sends it rink wide in front of his teammates, and Matthew Bragg will get it up here to DaCosta. 1-on-2, rolling puck held on, and DeSeris will freeze it. A little bit after the fact, and the officials aren't very happy here, and there might be a penalty or two, and I think there will be.
He's trying to settle things down a little bit. And good for Lacombe there just to guard their goaltender. Well, there is some chitter-chatter. Gannon for Lacombe, and Rob Heise, the nifty stick handler for Stoney Creek. Talk about the goal scorer, Jared Conkle, 35-year-old from Toronto, Ontario. And he's not playing hockey and scoring goals. He's the director of regional recruiting for Freedom 55 Financial, an MBA from Clarkson after playing at Elmira College. The assistant captain his last two seasons there. So 5-on-5 hockey resumes. They don't go to 4-on-4 in these incidental penalties.
Tegan Moore will stride it up to center ice. Cranbois lost control for Lacombe, trying to work it out in front. That didn't find its mark. And coming back the other way now is Nathan Pageau. You remember and you notice that last name, Pageau, the cousin to the Ottawa Senators, J.G. Pageau. Hurry number 14 here for Stoney Creek. His teammates will retreat back for it here as Martin Lee makes a move right side to Scott Hatham. Hatham will slow it down. Head up towards center ice, makes his way up to the red line, and then he's going to lift it high over everybody with a pretty good backhand.
Mentioned how Stoney Creek's defense really controls games, and now they're a little bit more comfortable to moving back to the defense, trying to spring a man behind the Lacombe's defensemen who are kind of backing off a little bit earlier in the neutral zone.
Justin Donati had the opening goal for Stoney Creek tonight. Now Brad Stepner gets it up ahead, and Velcourt will get it down. Blanchard with Jesse Todd right behind him. Stepner keeps it in at the blue line. Just on top of it here is Heisman's. In behind the goal to Velcourt. Takes a check from Blanchard. Helped and worked free here by Ricks. The assistant captain trying to move away from Fergus. The puck is elevated ahead, and now Donati is 1-on-2. Floats it to the left wing side. Here's Tuzzolino with a backhand. Put it off the side of the net. Donati in the left wing corner. Stoney Creek with a 2-1 lead, trying to expand that here as we are just over 3 minutes remaining in the first period here tonight in Rosetown.
Now the Donati twins for Stoney Creek, the East Coast League equivalent of the Sedins. They both won scoring titles and 1-2 in that league. They played more together than they have apart throughout their careers.
Been able to play overseas as well as Brown's able to hold that puck. Quick whistle by the referee who lost sight of it there. A chance on the doorstep for Miles Bell, but David Brown, who's been one of the best goalies this entire week, is able to keep his club up by one.
Digging away at the puck and then moving out front. Miles Bell last year in the Allen Cup final had 5 points in 5 games. He's pointless coming into this one. The former Regina Patton flown a rocket. He played defense, Munsey, until getting to Kelowna, and they converted him to a forward.
High off the glass. It's played to center ice there by Darren Cousins. Now a 2-on-1, left wing side, shooting and firing it just wide is Chris Hewlett. Cousins in behind the net, poking at it is Deck. O'Mara, the former Edmonton Oiler. Now Kunkel on the doorstep, gets taken down by Bell. Kunkel had the go-ahead goal. Now this line here of Hewlett fires one on goal. Stop again there by DeSeris. Kunkel gets taken down, and Bell's going to get a penalty. Puck is steered into the stands. And with a one-goal lead, the Stoney Creek Generals will have a power play here in the last couple of minutes of the first frame.
It's real good hard work. First in front of the net. You've got Hewlett battling around. Conkle, the goal scorer, is the one that gets knocked down. That's the penalty, the cross-check. get one, you get two, but that third one's going to get called. And Brown O'Mara was in front of that, battling around as well. Talked about how the power play settled in and helped Stony Creek. They get a chance here late in the first.
Miles Bell takes his first penalty this week. One for two, the power play. Puck ripped around the near wing side by Brennan Evans. And Stony Creek will set up on the power play, back in their zone, all the way back in behind David Brown.
What they're going to want to do is this big man with the puck, Nick Tuzzolino. He can fire it. They're going to try to set him up for the one-timer.
Rob Heisey will carry it in. Pass just out of the reach there. And Tuzzolino's going to retreat back here, being watched on the penalty kill by Cannon up front, is wearing number 20. Now here comes Gondolski, 22. Right pad saved by DeSeris. Rebound, Gondolski right on again. And DeSeris is able to cover up.
Good battle by Gondolski there. He's going to be the net front guy from born in the Ukraine, Kiev, and then transferred over to play his hockey here. Just a shot that gets blocked and he stays on it. He's a rabble rouser. You'll see him try to battle in front of the net. But he's getting pulled off at this moment.
Power play will pretty much take us through to the remaining moments here in this first period. Stony Creek has scored back-to-back goals. DaCosta, top of the right wing circle now. Here's Nick Donati, or Tyler Donati, pardon me. Back to the midpoint now to Donati. Shot blocked there, right at the blue line, battling and unable to clear is Keegan Moore. Moore will now get it, and he'll risk it right on net in on Brown. And he'll play it out actively. That's good stick handling ability by Brown. Heisey floats it in, left wing corner. Gray takes a body check there from Heisman's. Blanchard tees up a slap shot, blocker save, and DeZeris will put it out of the play.
17, Sean Blanchard, that's the captain for Stony Creek. Nelly King's draft pick back in 97. And he's played all over London, Italy, Switzerland. Actually played against Blanchard in Switzerland. I was in Martinet. He was with the Zurich Lions, the B team, and battled in front of the net with him.
Cam Fergus with under a minute to go in the opening period. Gives it back to Costa. Blanchard scores! Blows it by the stick side of Jacob DeSeris. And Stony Creek has a pair of power play goals, and they now lead it 3-1.
DeSeris not happy. He could not see that come through. As they try to get the puck back to the point, talk about the strength of their defenseman. Moved across. This isn't a hard one-timer. It's just in the right spot. John Blanchard, the captain. That's his first goal of the tournament. And he puts his team up, Stony Creek, 3-1 late in the first with another power play marker.
One of the oldest players in the event, able to score a big goal for his team here, 2 for 3 on the power play this evening. After getting behind one early on, they've been able to rattle off 3 in a row. And talked to both coaches prior to the game here tonight. They had mentioned that penalties would be the Achilles heel for one of them. And so far, that's something that Lacombe will need to get better here with 40 minutes to go.
Well, Coach Brian Hamm for Stony Creek had said that don't call a lot of penalties in the league that he, his team plays in, and it's been a bit of an adjustment for his group staying out of the box. They've done so far.
Stick around. Coming up in our first intermission, we'll talk to one of the Stony Creek generals, and we'll also take you through the history of the Allen Cup. This tournament and trophy has been handed out since 1909, and a special feature coming up between our first and second periods this evening, so stick around for that. One more face-off here close to David Brown, who all of a sudden doesn't have as many shots towards him as he had early on, with his team being able to play more at the other end of the ice in the last half of the period. Cam Fergus, Jesse Todd on the drop, and that's going to do it for the opening period. Jesse, one more try. Probably wouldn't have counted. The shot was let go with the buzzer. And the first period is complete in the final game of this 2018 Senior Men's Canadian Hockey Championship, where the hometown Lacombe Generals, who are about 4 hours away from friends and family, find themselves down too, Dave.
Well, we'll see which team is able to readjust to the penalties being called here after the first period.
3-1, Stony Creek. We'll talk to them next.
season, more than 100 teams take to the ice with hopes of playing at Canada's National Female Midget Championship, the Esso Cup. Premier marketing partner of Hockey Canada, Imperial Oil is proud to help the growth of women's hockey across Canada. Visit hockeycanada.ca/EssoCup.
In the heart of the prairies, the AGT Center has been the site of the Allen Cup all week long. The round robin began on Monday, and here we are 40 minutes away from handing out the championship trophy for 2018. Let's talk to one of the Stoney Creek Generals who has one of the goals here tonight. And after a 1-0 deficit, what was the difference for your club to be able to rattle off three straight goals other than the power play?
Well, they came out hard, so we kind of had to match that. Getting three power plays and capitalizing on two of them, that's always good. So we just have to keep getting pucks deep and keep relying on our legs here.
Justin, we talked to your coaches about the experience for the Allen Cup. What has it meant to you to be involved in this event this week?
Yeah, it's a great event. Rosetown did a really good job hosting it. Again, we were in Bouctouche last year. They did a great job, too. So it's been a great experience. We've had a lot of fun so far.
It's been a lot of fun hockey we've seen so far this week with 40 minutes remaining. All the best. Thanks for your time.
All right, thank you.
Justin Donati joining us, the 31-year-old out of Oakville, Ontario. Well, as you can see, Generals is a very popular name. The past Allen Cup champions, that is the same franchise here. They've just moved locations. Not very far away, Bentley to Lacombe. Strong, rich tradition for the Alberta champions here tonight. One of the representatives from Ontario trying to add their name to this trophy that's been handed out since 1909.
When Frederick Arthur Lord Stanley of Preston donated the Dominion Hockey Challenge Cup in 1893, it was intended to honor the amateur hockey champion of Canada. However, as money began to corrupt the principle of amateurism, the Stanley Cup, as it came to be known, became virtually the sole possession of professional teams. As a result, the desire to honor true amateur competition led to the creation of a new challenge trophy in 1908.
There was a league formed in Montreal called the Interprovincial Amateur Hockey Association, or Union, I think it was called. Some of the guys from Montreal went to Sir Henry Montagu Allen and asked for him to donate a trophy, and he did.
Trustees of the league were determined not to let economics taint the amateur spirit of the Allen Cup. Therefore, outside of team expenses, all proceeds from the gate were donated to local charities. Champions of the Allen Cup were subject to the challenge system, whereby challengers would apply to a panel of three trustees for the right to play the champion for the cup. However, disputes over eligibility of participants and where and when challenge matches would be played threatened the cup's very survival. On December 4th, 1914, in an effort to bring some order to this chaos, the Canadian Amateur Hockey Association was formed, and the challenge system was abandoned in favor of playdowns.
The playdown system that was created an enormous number of teams and leagues across the country. You had senior leagues everywhere, and every one of those senior leagues had a champion, and every one of those champions played in their region, and the whole goal of that was to get to the Allen Cup. All these small centers were able to have players come to town, settle into the town, become part of the town, give them jobs, and yet at the same time play hockey.
A perfect example of such a community is Trail BC, a mining town in southern British Columbia. The Trail Smoke Eaters are not only two-time Allen Cup champions, but they were world champions as well.
It became tradition that the Allen Cup winner would go to the Olympics. And then when they started the World Championships a few years later, they decided that they would also send the Allen Cup champion to play in the Worlds.
The final Allen Cup champion to conquer the world, the 1961 Smoke Eaters were also Canada's last world champion for 33 years until the drought was broken in 1994. Over the 100-year history of the Allen Cup, the faces have changed, the format has changed, and even the prize has changed, as in 1993, the original trophy was retired and replaced with an identical replica. And like the plaques honoring Allen Cup alumni who went on to great NHL careers, the original trophy itself and memorabilia from its history take their rightful place within the walls of the Hockey Hall of Fame.
Thank you, Rod. Justin Donati had his club down one and then led his Stony Creek team to three straight goals.
Road to the RBC Cup is a long one. As a premier marketing partner of Hockey Canada, RBC supports teams in their quest to reach Canada's National Junior A Championship. For more information, visit hockeycanada.ca/RBC Cup.
Let's take a look at the opening period. The Lacombe Generals able to strike first tonight, Dave Tomlinson.
They opened the scoring in the semifinal, and they opened the scoring here in the final. That's Bartow. He scored the fourth goal in the 4-on-1 in the semifinals. Gets Lacombe up 1-0. But the power play, the 5-on-3. Donati just off the post, bangs it in. And here's that centering pass that is errant, and then in. Conkle, the assistant captain, celebrates. And we get a look at a power play marker again. Through a screen, a heavy slap shot from the captain, Sean Blanchard, past the blocker side. And it's been special teams in favor of Stony Creek. They were being outshot early. They outshot Lacombe, as you see, 16-13 after 20 minutes.
Sean Blanchard able to get a big goal. The 3-1 marker, the 40-year-old, one of the players that his head coach, Brian Hamm, talked to us pregame about here tonight. You've been around as long as him. You appreciate events like this even more. And a chance to be able to find the score sheet never hurts as well for a guy that's been rock solid in front of his goaltender, David Brown. On the other side, we'll bring you back in for second period play-by-play. It's the Allen Cup here on TSN. The IIHF Men's Under-18 World Championship comes your way Thursday when Team Canada takes on Team USA. Puck drop is at 10:30 a.m. Eastern, 7:30 Pacific, across the TSN network.
Two helpers tonight for Cam Fergus. He's used to getting hit in his non-hockey playing time. He's a stuntman. If you watch the Goon movies, you'd see him in there. And talk about dedication. He left Punta Cana to come here to play in the Allen Cup final.
Good opportunity for him here tonight to win an Allen Cup championship. He's familiar to this event. Third time he's played in it. Last couple of years, of course, with this Stony Creek team. 3 years ago with the Grand Falls Windsor Cataracts, who, by the way, are the defending champions, coming in after last season's victory in Buktoosh, New Brunswick, over these Lacombe Generals. Big collision there between Evans and Conkle.
Sorry, a 7-4 loss for Lacombe. They had played five games in just under 5 days, and they got worn down to the nub.
Conkle will backhand it in from that big Red Wing logo at center ice. Puck rattled right off the side glass near wing side, where it's handled now by Martin Lee. Rink wide in front of the Lacombe bench. Taking it now is Desmond in 3-on-3. Kanan Desmond deals it down, taken away now by Scott Hatham. Conkle will backhand the puck. Doug Jesse chipping it here, looking for Valcourt, went too far for it. And Lee will whip it right onto the tape of Fergus, who you mentioned moments ago. Now to Scott Hatham across the Lacombe line. He'll drop it off. Slap shot ricochets up over the glass and out of play.
Talking with the coach, Brian Hamm, he said he was going to try to run as much as he can with two of his top defensemen. Tuzzolino is one of them, who was serving a suspension and only got into the last game for Stony Creek, that victory over the Southeast Prairie Thunder.
Fergus and Todd to face off to the glove side of Desers. If you're just joining us tonight, Lacombe scored first, Ian Bartow, and then three consecutive goals here by the Ontario champions, who will send another one towards the goaltender. Able to give them the 2-0 advantage right now here in the second period.
It's the goaltender, Jacob Desers, that made the easy glove stop there. He works for Milwaukee Tool, who's a district manager. Talked about his Memorial Cup win in 2011.
Here comes Lacombe, trying to bust outside in a hurry. Colin Valcourt trying to put it on the doorstep. He did. Great pass, but a big pad stop as David Brown was able to get over there. And Valcourt is shaken up in behind the goal, the 25-year-old out of Prince George, British Columbia. And it looks like the Generals, as a result, will get their first power play of the night. But the concern right now is for Colin Valcourt.
Well, it's Darren Cousins, the defenseman, who was caught backpedaling and had to dive. He'll come to your screen there. And it's that last moment where the hip comes up. And it's a tripping call for Cousins. Going heavy into the boards was Valcourt.
Right leg kind of slammed right into the Bowers side there, and looks like the upper body took a lot of the brunt as well.
He's in some serious pain. Valcourt from Prince George, BC, former Spokane Chief, Saskatoon Blade, and Prince Albert Raider. He's going to stay at the bench. But Lacombe, more importantly, goes on their first power play of the evening.
Lacombe's power play, just two-man advantage markers so far this week. Great opportunity for them to get right back in it right now. Nathan Deck gets a short pass here from Dennis Ricks. Puck is stolen away, though, shorthanded. Sharp angle from Nathan Peugeot. Comes off the wall, and Bell will set it up. Nowakowski takes a check, continues with it around Blanchard. Deck has it rolling to him. We'll set up the power play right now here for Lacombe. Back to Miles Bell, the former Regina Pat. Sends it off a leg there. That one hit Heisey. On the penalty kill, Blanchard all the way out. Guess he couldn't knock it down with his stick, and the penalty killers will change up here for Stoney Creek. Doug Jesse, the 26-year-old, snaps it up to center ice. Taken there by Gondolski back in his own zone. Hoffman will rag some time off on the penalty kill right now to Martin Lee, and he'll put it the rest of the way down. Up in quickly, though, is Gondolski. Back door, too far for Bragg. Gondolski killing off some time down and behind the Lacombe goal. 3-1 the score. Stoney Creek in front, working on the penalty kill right now. Here's Nowakowski. Marshall couldn't find it, now he will. Glove it down with his left hand. Bill Marshall. Can't keep possession, though. Nowakowski hard in after it. Take it on the PK, and with just over a half minute remaining in the first power play of the night, the Generals will keep it in here as Bartow will send it into the corner. Lacombe looking for their fourth Allen Cup championship on the power play. Here's Bartow. Takes a shot. Over on the far wing, Brennan Evans gives it back here to Ian Bartow, who's got the goal tonight for Lacombe. Wrist shot through a maze. Hit a body in front. And Fergus will take it safely. His buddy Darren Cousins is about to come out of the penalty box. And DeSeres took a bump right on the doorstep there from Cam Fergus. And that draws a bit of an ire here from some of those Lacombe defenders.
Well, three quarters of the way through that power play, nothing really happened for Lacombe. Couldn't get set up. Finally, it's a D to D and a shot that eventually gets through. But looks like it's punched away by the goaltender and then easily take it out of the zone. So the Stoney Creek group is just about to have this killed off. 3 seconds left.
And that will officially do it here for Darren Cousins. And Stoney Creek is back to 5-on-5 play. That power play over the last couple of minutes resulted in just one shot for Lacombe. Gannon now with a 2-on-1. Has Sheen going to the net. Gannon shoots and he missed. Put it up high and wide as it ricochets all the way down the ice to Deck. Hard off the boards in front of the Stoney Creek bench. Dangling with it there is Desmond. Joining in on the play. Going to the goal is Deck. Turned back out the other way, though. And up in high gear is Rob Heisey. Heisey uses the defender as a screen. Played it to the side of the goal, back in behind the cage. Gannon with a backhand pass. Comes off now to Kyle Sheen. And he'll look with his head up, looking to get his Lacombe teammates back to within one.
Well, he had two different opportunities. The 2-on-1, Lacombe misses the net. And then when Stoney Creek comes down, they just shovel it towards the goaltender.
Hewlett let a wrist shot go. That goes off the blocker of DeSeres. Sheen will set it up. Dalrymple over on the far side. Aerials it up high through the air. One of the great features here of the old AGT Center is the high open roof. It gives a chance for players to move it up right down the middle of the ice. And we're going to see an interference penalty coming up, I think, away from play.
And DeCosta's not happy about it, as he's getting ticketed. I think it's a high stick, an errant stick, after that pass was over to his D partner, Tozzolino. So after having a pretty respectable first period, staying out of the penalty box, Stoney Creek is in there consecutively. This is a pass across, and just that errant stick clips right under the chin. Lacombe with back-to-back power plays.
Stony Creek scored two power play goals in the first period. Barteau from the line let it go off the side of the post. Barteau with it again. Over on the far boards now, Blanchard will battle for it. Tuzzolino will take it free. There has not been a shorthanded goal scored between these teams so far this week. Stony Creek on the power play with three so far coming into the game tonight. Added two more to give them five, while Lacombe was 2 for 8 coming in, now working on their second try, and now there's a penalty coming up, and another one coming here to Stony Creek. Ian Barteau, slap shot right into a leg. Belcourt had it hit him. And for the next 1 minute and 18 seconds, Nick Tuzzolino will make his way to the penalty box, and it's a 5-on-3 Lacombe power play.
That's a costly penalty. Tuzzolino with the trip right there, lost the puck and just panicked for a moment there. So you can see being just encroached upon and loses the handle and sits a minute 18, 5-on-3. We saw Stony Creek score in their 5-on-3 chance in the first period. Time for Lacombe to answer back.
Dylan Nowakowski on the faceoff, lost it. Lacombe's Jesse can't keep it in. Played off the boards there by Rob Heisey all the way down. Nathan Deck quickly here on the 5-on-3 with just over 60 seconds remaining in it. Deck hits the line. Watched up there with Cousins. Battling for the puck is Marshall. In behind the goal, Nowakowski to Bell. Bell wanted to float it to Marshall. That lane was stolen away. Jesse keeps it in with room. Diving. Oh, what a block there. Sacrificing his body on the penalty kill is Darren Cousins, who will limp his way over to the Stony Creek bench. Nowakowski with it again for Lacombe. Drop pass. Bell shot. That goes off the leg of Lee. Jesse Todd had problems with it there, and then it's slapped off by Scott Hotham back into Lacombe ice. 5-on-3 for 25 more seconds. Bell scores! Miles Bell gets Lacombe back to within one. A 5-on-3 power play goal.
Bell rings it past the goaltender on the glove side. And that's the second goal of the night for Lacombe. A gutsy play earlier was the shot block. And this is what we were talking about with Cousins barely making it to the bench. But back on the re-entry into the zone, Lacombe was able to gain it easily. And a shot through a screen and a glove that just, the puck goes off it and in. And Lacombe was able to capitalize and claw back.
Miles Bell with a goal here tonight in Rosetown. Started his junior career here in the province with the Regina Pats. Just under 50 seconds remaining now in the third power play of the game that continues for Lacombe. They are now 1-for-2. Ian Barteau, who had the first period goal, will stride out to center ice. The 29-year-old out of Fort Saskatchewan, Alberta, takes it wide left, gets around Lee. Deals down and behind the net. Skating for the puck is Jesse Todd. He'll feed Brennan Evans at the right point. Back around the perimeter. Todd floats it into the right wing corner, and Evans. Evans with his head up. Doesn't pull the trigger. Now he will. That hit a body in front and went off Blanchard, and the puck goes sailing into the Lacombe bench out of play.
Some block shots by Stony Creek, but they're looking a little fatigued coming into this second period, taking back-to-back-to-back minors. And with that, the 5-on-3 that Lacombe capitalized on, 14 more seconds. And then Tuzzolino, the big defenseman, will be able to join his Stony Creek teammates out for 5-on-5 action.
Lacombe wins the faceoff. Eloquently won there by Devin Gannon. Sharp angle try by Bill Marshall. Pulls it again out of his skates. Has Deck coming in. Could put it on his tape. Deck gets outside here on Pajot. Played it side of the goal. They jam away. Brown's trying to find it. There's a mess of bodies in front of him. And he is able to make the save with just over 12 and a half minutes remaining here in the second period. The Stony Creek Generals getting themselves in a little bit of penalty trouble. And Miles Bell has Lacombe back to within one.
Well, Lacombe gets on the board. after a power pay marker from Miles Bell, number 74. He's an instructor at Elite Hockey School. I don't know if he can teach that shot. Just leaned into it, bent the blade and the shaft of the stick and tickled the twine.
He'll take that one back to school and show everybody that he's teaching. See, this is how you do it. Modern technology these days.
Let the stick do the work.
That's right. Able to pick his spot, the one, David Brown. Bell looking for another one, but sacrificing his Hewlett. Now a rocket on the left side. Just did Brown get a piece of that?
I think it went
out of play.
He had a hurry up into the netting.
Oh.
They have the glass on the one side, the high netting on the other. It's a face-off play. Bell tries to get it through. It's blocked. And here's Deck. Boom. I think this puck was up on end and rifles out.
Like he was taking part in the hardest slap shot competition, the way he strided into it with nobody in front. Another penalty coming up here. It's a tripping minor. Stony Creek again.
And again, it's the defenseman, Darren Cousins. Another tripping call from Georgetown, Ontario. The young defenseman loses the puck for a moment, gets the stick between the legs and can't get it out. 31-year-old's gonna sit and hope his team can kill this one off.
Lacombe 1-for-3 on the power play tonight. They've scored on their lone shot on goal. See if they can generate more here towards Brown. Players battling for it. Travis Grandwall along the end wall wearing 17. Lost possession of it. And it's sent all the way down the ice by Ryan O'Mara, the former Edmonton Oiler, who's wearing jersey number 18 here for Stony Creek. In on the forecheck. Knocks his man off balance. Bell able to get it with a backhand here to Deck. Grandbois joins him. Now a penalty coming up as Deck and Martin Lee got in close company, and it looks like Lee may be bleeding.
This was Deck coming in and trying to control the puck along the boards. And he's the one going to the penalty box. As talked about it in the opening, just the shiftiness. Puts it off the boards, tries to get in and dig for that puck. Instead, it's up into the nose of Lee, and it's a double minor for Nathan Deck. So some 4-on-4 for minute 34, and then Stony Creek will get a rare power play. It's been all Lacombe on the power play here in the second.
4-3 right now. Stony Creek out shooting Lacombe in the second period. Lacombe with the only goal, though, the power play marker. Here comes Donati. Light shot, put it up high off his stick again, and that one goes out of play on the glass back in behind Jacob DeSeris tonight.
Well, Lacombe is, as we mentioned, just it's almost second nature for them to get to the finals. Their general manager, Jeff McGinnis, nice man, had a nice chat with him today, saying his job in getting players is to help them go from pro to Joe, just an average Joe playing hockey.
A lot of special talents on this sand-colored team, though, tonight, including Nolan Heismans, who went racing down the ice towards Brown.
There's the gentleman we were talking about, Jeff McGinnis. It was now the second year that Lacombe can call the Generals their own team. It was the Bentley Generals before that. This is their 50th Allen Cup game. And they're trying to claw their way back.
They've taken part in 8 of the last 10 championships that have been held across our great country. They only have 3 wins. So one of the key focal points today that Jeff mentioned was getting back to within one game of that 500 mark here in Rosetown. Here comes Nolan Heismans on a 3-on-2. Barteau and Todd will join him. Todd the pass, shoots. What a stick getting back there defensively by Blanchard. Sean Blanchard, the cap that has been tremendous here tonight for Stony Creek. Now Fergus has a break near side pass. What a stop! Oh, Jacob DeSeris, the save of the game so far.
That was a 2-on-0 because Lacombe was slow in the change. Ryan O'Mara cannot believe it. It was a chance down one end that wasn't converted. Blanchard, you mentioned, just got the stick in. This is a blatant 3-on-2. And Lacombe just falls asleep for a moment. Watch the top of your screen. They're all going to change. It turns into this. And the left pad getting across from DeSaris. My goodness. That was a big stop.
That's the one of the game so far. Keeping his club to within one right now. Doug Jesse will bobble it down the ice. Jesse first man in on the attack. Nowakowski joining him as well. Rick's covering up on the near point, will wheel back. Stoney Creek's Martin Lee will try and find it here to Heisey. That one missed. Justin DeCosta behind the goal, and Stoney Creek just trying to sort things out a little bit here as we are close to the midway point of the game.
And now they have a over 2 minute power play from the tail end of that high sticky double minor from one of the best defensemen from the Combs, Nathan Deck.
Stoney Creek's 2 for 3 on the power play tonight. They have had 6 shots in on goal. Here's a big reason why they're good on the power play. It's Nick Tuzzolino, the 32-year-old out of Buffalo. Gets it left side to Scott Hatham, who will get it the rest of the way down. DeSaris will set it up. That's run around the wall. And it gets outside on Hoffman. And now there's a foot race for it. Desmond, partial 2-on-1 with Gannon. Desmond over his stick. And unable to knock it down is Devin Gannon. Barteau will just play it from the red line. Back into Stoney Creek ice.
There's a saucer pass from Desmond that didn't have any landing gear.
One thing that's been talked about by all 6 teams that have played this week here in Rosetown inside the AGT Center is how good the ice has been.
And they brought a second compressor to keep it fresh and get some very quick puck movement through these games all the way here to the final.
Fergus with 2 assists back in the first period, takes a hit there from Barteau. Now Granbois angles it off the glass, high over everybody. Blanchard's going to go back. Brown, his goaltender, will leave it for the captain and behind his net. Left side pass comes to Hewlett. Jesse steps up at center ice. That one's knocked down by Conkle. Blanchard controlling again. Bragg and Fergus up front. 45 seconds remaining here in the Stoney Creek power play. Fergus, far wing, shoots off the stick of a defender, is able to get his blade in front of it as Doug Jesse. And we'll see a faceoff coming up here in neutral ice.
Well, you want to try to capitalize on your odd man rushes. And there was no better than earlier for Stoney Creek. As on a poor change, you've got Fergus, who's sitting on 2 helpers, trying to get 3 there. O'Mara just can't believe he can't get it up over the pad.
Ryan O'Mara played 33 games in his NHL career with the Edmonton Oilers and Anaheim Ducks. Heisman's able to get outside on Blanchard. Shoots, pad save, rebound, he scores! Jesse Todd! What a play! Jesse Todd has been brilliant all week for the Lacombe Generals. And it's a brand new night here on the Prairies. It's 3-3.
Just a mess up off the faceoff and then the up ice pressure. We've seen this from Lacombe. And the pass across. Todd is able to bang it in. Jesse Todd from Calgary. He's got 3 goals coming into this final. Add another one to make it 4, and we're tied at 3.
A goal and an assist in this period for number 97, Jesse Todd. Players battling behind the goal. Brown had to get back in his crease. And that's the first shorthanded goal that either of these teams, Lacombe or Stoney Creek, has been able to score here since round-robin play began on Monday. Donati sets up here. Cousins trying to hold the line. Can't do it, and it's a breakaway. In alone, Keenan Desmond to give them the lead. Pad save kicked out by David Brown. What a stop. After back-to-back goals, one on the power play and one shorthanded for the Lacombe Generals, Desmond with all sorts of time can't put it home.
Oh, this is for the highlight reel for the goaltender David Brown. Keenan Desmond shorthanded after Lacombe scored shorthanded to tie the game. Can't get him to bite. That fake to the backhand just goes on the dragging left pad. And Brown feels comfortable in net.
when we walked into the arena here today, early this afternoon, and started to finalize preparations for the rosters that would be involved with the two coaches here today, one of the organizers looked at us and said, "We'd love to have had our Rosetown Red Wings in the game here tonight, but these two teams are going to put on a game, and they have not disappointed so far, have they?"
It was Lacombe, better in the first until the power play took over for Stoney Creek, and then just take that and flip the switch, hand the script back, and Lacombe's power play comes to life, and then a shorthanded marker. We see two beautiful saves, one we showed you earlier from David Brown, but before that, it was almost 2-on-0. DeSaris was able to keep the score tied. Some turning points by some big saves from both goaltenders.
Stoney Creek giving up the last two goals in the game right now, but they're still out shooting Lacombe, but it's close, 20-19. In the lead right now of the Ontario representatives as DeSaris will punch that one into the corner. Blanchard backhands it. Sheen will send it cross ice. Rick's trying to glove it down. Good play to navigate the blue line there as he wrists it over top of the goal. Big hit in the corner as Sheen went crunching down there from Blanchard. Now Brown with a blocker save of a sharp angled shot from Dennis Ricks. Here's Lacombe once more. Deck plays it in behind the goal. Wanted Sheen. Can't find it. A body check into the corner there. Ricks battling with his man, Fergus. Tegan Moore sidestepped the collision. And now it's a possible 3-on-2 rush. Can Fergus make this happen for Stoney Creek? No, they can't. Play it off here to O'Mara. Gannon's all by his lonesome. Takes it wide right, looking for reinforcement, going to the goal. Gannon still protecting it here against a pair of Stoney Creek players in Bragg and 44, Darren Cousins, who's been active on the blue line tonight. DaCosta gave it away. Stebner gets it down low for Desmond. Under 6 minutes to play now in the second period. 3-3 the score. Gannon ran out of room down in behind the Stoney Creek net. Dancing with it in behind the goal. Generals trying to get their lead back. They had a 1-0 lead early in the first period. Pumped right back in here by Dalrymple. Cousins banks it off the boards in front of the Lacombe bench. This one will not be called for icing. And Stoney Creek wants to get a line change in. Lacombe right in after it now. Pace is starting to pick up a little bit here.
And it's Lacombe that's setting it.
Barteau's shot didn't get through. He was the one, by the way, that had that first period goal. Now Heise is going to slow down the play here for a minute. Wait for everybody to make sure they're in a blue uniform they want. 2-on-1 steal. Jesse Todd has Colin Belcourt with him. Todd dangles. Back check, though. Stopped by Jared Conkle as he helps out his team defensively on a big play.
Stoney Creek has been coughing the puck up on the entry, and they do it again. Here's Todd. Who's looking to make the pass, but that's Heise, the forward, who's helping out, diving at the right moment. Looks like Todd's going to do the toe drag and the shot. We've seen his shot. This one doesn't get off the toe as it's obstructed towards the goaltender, Brown. Stoney Creek's got to get their energy level up.
You wonder if that's the experience of the Lacombe Generals paying off a little bit here in this event.
Well, when they flex their muscles, not too many teams can stay with them. Lacombe is usually the more physical team.
And they played one last game during round robin as well. And what Stoney Creek had to do, now Dylan Nowakowski comes in, shoots, stick save, and he runs into the side of the net. Looks like everybody's okay on that collision.
Nowakowski couldn't quite turn, so he stays on his original angle towards the net. Calgarian there doesn't want to hit the goaltender, so instead he uses the post to stop up. The BCHL with the Victoria Grizzlies and the Alberni Bulldogs, and then went to the College of Saints Scholastica in Duluth, Minnesota. The Saints of Scholastica.
I think the pad would have been a little softer of the goalie. But that's respected the game, as you've alluded to. And done a lot of homework on leading into this thing. These guys are the regular Joe that, well, they'll have tomorrow, but then it's back to work on Monday.
Certainly is. And talk about a lot of these players that have the dream to play in the NHL. It passes them by. They bounce around from different leagues, and then they've got to settle back into regular life, but they still want to play hockey. And that's the beauty of this tournament. In coming to a small town here like Rosetown, population 2,500, the Red Wings couldn't make it to the final. Great crowd here and a great game as well. Back and forth action. But these guys, at least one of these teams, will walk out of here with a trophy.
Nathan Deck lets it go from the blue line. Turned away by Brown. Far wing side, Ricks taking Fergus, gave it away in behind the net. Ricks makes a move, has Moore in front, has Sheen as well along the near wing side. Floats it off a leg to the defenseman. Nathan Deck, a tight turn to get away from his man. Now a penalty's coming up. Stoney Creek's going to get a probable slashing call here. Stick came right out of the hands of the former Brandon Wheat King captain, Tegan Moore.
Well, Ryan O'Mara's not happy. The battle, you know, anytime a player's reaching for the puck, you still want to try to get his stick and see if you can't get that puck. This is into the hands first and then knocks the stick clean out. So penalty trouble again for Stoney Creek with 3:52 on the clock. As you can see, this is going to be a big kill for them.
This is five straight power plays that Lacombe has had in our middle frame. Trying to take their lead back after an early 1-0 lead. Now the puck goes up high and it's shaken up Rob Heise. Heise took that one, looks like on the left ear area right now in the penalty kill. Needs to get over to the bench, but Lacombe with some pressure here on the power play. At the right wing point, protecting it. What a move by Nathan Deck. Side of the net, give and go. They can't get it. And the puck is shot down, and the Stoney Creek Generals from Ontario will get a big line change.
And that was Heise who was able to clear it. Just checking himself at right, pardon me, that left ear crack at the bench.
Just under 80 seconds remaining here on this power play. It's wristed in high. Miles Bell gets locked up there with Matthew Bragg. Bell skates away with it. Gets as far as the blue line, has some problems with that bouncing puck. Marteau will get it. Oh, what a hit there as he gets stepped into by Sean Blanchard.
And you can feel the glass rattle, and we're standing about 15 feet from that, where we're standing rattle too.
Yeah, we've got a great vantage point here tonight inside the AGT Center. We're about six rows off the glass, right on top of the penalty box. Doesn't get much better than this. And you're not going to get much better of a game than we've had so far here that has really gone back and forth all night long with 2.5 to play now in our second period.
Oh, a 3-3 tie. Shots are 22-21. Heise here trying to kill the penalty. And just gets a stick that the referees missed. And then we're going to see this heavy hit. Bam! Marteau took that one. The captain of Stoney Creek makes his presence felt.
Wristed off the glass all the way down. Marteau gets it from his goalie. Nathan Pageau in on the forecheck. Now it's Marteau. Power play continuing here for just over 20 seconds. Wrist shot right into the gear, and Brown will take it off the left shoulder, and he will hang on to it.
Marteau is a teacher at a middle school of a hockey academy. And he's been the glue back there for Lacombe throughout this tournament. Powerful skater, good shot, saw that in the first period.
Former member of the Kootenay Ice in the Western Hockey League. Brennan Evans waiting at the midpoint, wants to let a one-time shot go. Nobody got him in the puck as Marteau, who we just mentioned, battles down and behind the Stoney Creek goal now. Marshall able to dig it out. Teams are ready to come back to 5-on-5. Gannon holds it in at the line. Marteau loses it there. Cousins plays it off. Sent off the wall now by Lee. Foot race for it here. Marshall. Pageau gets underneath him, and he had it bounce off his blades in between his feet. He couldn't kick it. Now a chance, and Fergus had the puck jump on him as he was set up on that right side. Tuzzolino will pound it into Marteau's equipment. Stoney Creek with a bit of a push here in the last 80 seconds of our second period, in which they've been outscored by a 2-0 margin. We are in for a fantastic finish here tonight in Rosetown. Bragg spins it off the side wall. Puck is elevated out. Zuzzolino can't get it there. Nesbitt battles right in front of us, in front of the timekeeper. Cannon's going to lock it down with a minute to go. Barteau, who's played, what, 15, 16, 17 minutes already in tonight's game, is going to set up behind the net. He has logged a lot of ice. It's an endless night for him. Bell gets away now from Heise. Barteau's finally going to head off on a break. And Stoney Creek is going to be called for icing here with just over a half minute to play.
Well, Miles Bell, you see him here. He just got tied up, favoring his left leg right near the front of the net. But there was a little bit of a push there after the penalty kill for Stoney Creek, catching Barteau and his defensive partner out there for a bit of a longer shift. But that icing call will put this last faceoff with 33.2 on the clock in Stoney Creek zone.
Talk to one of the Lacombe Generals coming up in our second intermission tonight. And we'll also go one-on-one with Allen Cup Chairman Scott Murdoch. He and his organizing committee have just done a tremendous job this week. A lot of planning goes into something like this that goes from Monday to Saturday. And it has been well run. Scott and I will talk about the Allen Cup, and we'll also fill you in on the latest with our friends and families 2 hours east of us in Humboldt, as Humboldt Strong is decorated around the arena here tonight. Well, it's been a night tonight, and so far nothing's been settled. Three straight goals by Stoney Creek gave them the lead after one, but a power play and a shorthanded goal has the Alberta champions right back in it. Fans have been treated to an absolute gem here tonight in Rosetown, Saskatchewan, the 2018 Allen Cup Championship, and so far tonight, nothing has been settled. Well, Stoney Creek was able to have a pretty solid opening period. Lacombe able to come back with a power play and a shorthanded goal. Pleased to be joined by one of the veterans on this team, and let's start maybe right there. You guys have lost a lot of players coming into this one, but tonight you're one of the leaders, and what did you like about that second period?
Well, I think we got our feet moving a little bit more. I think maybe we had a good start in the first period there, and then we kind of let them take it to us. They scored on the power play, and then we kind of got down a bit. But, you know, we got a lot of veterans, like you said, in the room, and, our second period was great.
Brennan, the Saskatchewan guy, you're not far from your hometown of North Battleford. You rode the bus forever. What has this week meant for you with the Humboldt Broncos tragedy?
For me, it's really gone to show how small and how tight-knit the hockey world really is. Everyone, you know, you see the sticks out and the candles and the amount of money that they've raised for those guys in the GoFundMe. It's a incredible tragedy, but you know, it's amazing how everyone's come together for it.
Thank you, Brendan. Appreciate it. All the best in the final 20.
Thank you very much.
Brendan Evans is here tonight. Brendan Evans joining us here after 40 minutes of play. On the other side of the break, we'll tell you more about the Humboldt Broncos, the week that has been here in Rosetown for the 2018 Allen Cup. We'll go one-on-one with the tournament chair. Scott Murdoch joins us next here on TSN.
Players compete for a chance to play at Canada's National Midget Championship, the TELUS Cup. As the biggest fans of Canada's biggest game, TELUS is helping the hockey stars of today and tomorrow. Visit hockeycanada.ca/TELUS Cup.
After 40 minutes continues here tonight from the AGT Center in Rosetown, the heart of the prairies. And as you see in the windows, the hockey community has come together this week in both Humboldt and here in Rosetown. Pleased to be joined by the chairman of the Allen Cup, Scott Murdoch. And Scott, what a week it's been for your organizing committee, for yourself. We're down to the final game. We've got 20 minutes of regulation time left. What's the week been like for you?
It has been fantastic. A lot of planning, a lot of hard work went into this. Countless volunteers, so many hours, and just what we've seen all week long with the hockey, the crowds, everybody having a good time. It's been amazing.
The competition has been tight all the way since when round robin play began on Monday. And during that time and since, there's been a lot of special occasions inside the arena. There's been some outside as well, but bring us inside the facility here and some of the memories that'll stand out for you moving forward.
For sure, number one, be the opening ceremonies. One of the Rosetown Red Wings defensemen, David Stumborg, he was a Humboldt Bronco, he wore his Broncos jersey during the warm-up and to take the ceremonial face-off. That was one of the things for me that was probably one of the best moments of the tournament outside of the hockey.
Well, it has been a tragic week, obviously, for everybody in the game, and Humboldt's about 2 hours east of where we are here tonight. You mentioned the relationship with Stumberg and the Red Wings. Overall, when you take a look at the community, and we saw it again driving in from Saskatoon today, there's hockey sticks from Saskatoon to Rosetown all over the world. Your thoughts when you take a look at what we've seen and what's continuing to grow right now?
It's like you said, you drive around Rosetown, you see the sticks out on the doorsteps. There's a group of young men that were in Florida at the time for a selection camp. They're playing with Team Sask in baseball, and my nephew was actually playing on that team, and they observed a moment of silence in Florida. So the way it's brought everybody together around the world, it's heartwarming.
You had the Hunter brothers here last night. They took part in some of the remembrance ceremonies today for Broncos head coach and GM Darcy Hogan. Obviously special people in this area.
Absolutely. We love the Hunter brothers. JJ and Luke played for the Rosetown Red Wings. They played at our cabaret here last night, and they did a tribute for Humboldt. And at one moment, all the Rosetown Red Wings had lined up, and they were arm in arm. And it was such a touching moment, and it was nice to see.
Your group has done an outstanding job, Scott. You should be proud. Congratulations on everything that the Rosetown Red Wings and the city has been able to put together. Another very successful Allen Cup.
Thank you very much. We couldn't be happier.
Thoughts continue for the Humboldt Broncos and their families as well. Here tonight from the AGT Center. A number of players, as you see in that picture, have lost their lives. Our thoughts go to their families. And if you'd like to donate, like millions have across the world, you can do so on the GoFundMe page. Over $11 million already as we continue to remember the lives of those Humboldt Broncos affected. Sprite Raptors playoffs continue Tuesday when the Raptors take on the Wizards in game 2 of the first round. Catch the action at 6:30 Eastern, 3:30 Pacific across the TSN network and in 4K.
Well, quite a strong second period by Lacombe. A power play marker, that's Miles Bell finally getting one. You see the celebration there. Then the 2-on-1 shorthanded. The shot, the rebound, and the goal. Todd. And the 3-3 tie is preserved. That's Jacob DeSeris. There's one save, there's another. Making it look easy. This one was tough, and he got across. You think that was a good one here? The 2-on-0 and the toe save.
Taking a look at some of the numbers, especially in that second period of play. It was Generals, and you can see that Lacombe outshoots Stony Creek by a 2-1 margin. Stony Creek's first period, the reason why they're in it. And we have 20 minutes of regulation play remaining here as Jacob DeSeris will stare down Stony Creek. It's Alberta and Ontario. Will one more period be enough, or do we need to go for a little bit of a longer time here tonight and not have this 2018 championship close off just yet? Just like the last time that Lacombe was able to win in Steinbach, Manitoba. They beat the Southeast Prairie Thunder in overtime on a goal by Carter Rigby. Who will be the hero tonight, Dave?
Well, if it gets there, I'll give you one from both sides. That was 2016. They ran out of gas in 2017. Vic Touche. Lacombe, as we have talked about, are no stranger to playing in the final here of the Allen Cup.
Heisey will deal it in. DeSeris comes out of his goal into the skates of Porteau, takes a hit. Down along the end wall, Conkle trying to get it there. Tuzzolini lost the puck, and it's a 3-on-1. Here comes Lacombe. Bill Marshall, cross ice, scores! Ian Bartow made it 1-0. Now gives his club a 4-3 lead.
Another odd man rush as a pinch that goes wrong for Stony Creek ends up in the back of their net. Tosolino thinks he can keep the play alive. 6'5", the reach, can't. And you can hear everyone yelling three. Marshall looks across. Bartow looks up. That's almost bar down from Barteau, and 4-3 for Lacombe.
And a pair of goals in round robin and semifinal play coming in combined. Now he's got two in this one tonight. Started the scoring 2:45 into the opening period on just the game's fourth shot. And has logged a lot of ice tonight and has given the Alberta representatives their lead back.
Well, that's uncharacteristic of Stoney Creek. Their last game in the semifinals, it was their defense that was their backbone. Not allowing anything to get past them. No odd man rushes to speak of, but it's a different animal here in the final. Pressure builds, and Lacombe is coming on here early in the third.
Tanani will play it in. Sharp angled there from Hoffman. Able to get his right pad on it as Desairs. Now Nathan Deck, the former Raider, comes in with a former Patton Bell. Nowazowski in front, two. And Fergus comes the other way with a pair of assists tonight. He's going to be guilty of icing. And that'll bring the faceoff back into Stoney Creek ice.
Well, this might actually benefit Stoney Creek if they win the faceoff. Just settle things down. I don't think they believe coming into this third period they'd have to dig themselves back after a three-on-one is converted. And Lacombe, when you look at their bench, all standing, all invested in this game.
They are intrigued with what they've been able to do after facing a 3-1 deficit at one point here in the opening period. Darren Cousins will deal it down there against Stepner. A pair of generals run into each other from Lacombe there in behind the goal. Played off the wall now, and Hymans will play it out here for Lacombe. Left wing side for Jesse Todd. Hymans can't find it. Blanchard back the other way for Stoney Creek. Rink wide backhand pass onto the tape, and then falling down is Matthew Bragg. And there's going to be a tripping penalty as a result of that play. And after getting the go-ahead goal, there's going to be a minor penalty to the man we talked to in the intermission, Brennan Evans.
It looked like it was going to be a nothing play. It was thrown in the corner. Bragg driving the net. Evans trying to protect the middle of the ice. And that tripping call will put him in the penalty box. Stoney Creek gets a chance to answer back with their power play.
They were 2-for-3 back in the first period. They did not have a power play in the second period. Lacombe had 5 power plays in the second themselves. So let's see now what the Ontario representatives can do. Power play led by Nick Tuzzolino. We've said it 10 times tonight, and all of a sudden it just escaped me for a second. Here they come. Tuzzolino's here on the near wing side with all of his mates joining in on the forecheck. Donati pressured by Gannon in behind the goal. Donati with it again, rolls it over right side. This is Justin Donati. Tuzzolino waiting at the midpoint. Heisey gives it to him. Tuzzolino just missed glove side. Puck is chopped off Justin Donati's stick now over the end glass.
Well, they try to set him up for the big one-timer. Nick Tuzzolino is a welcome addition back to the blue line. And this is exactly what they're trying to do. Slow things down, draw attention, and then get it back to the point. Faceoff will come outside. Yeah, don't get the Tuzzolinos wrong. They've got the older brother, Tony, who also played hockey. He might just find you and say hi.
Well, Nick's 6'6", and as we are broadcasting 6 rows from the top of the glass here right now, he's pretty much eye level with us. What a player he's been, and he's got it right now. Left wing side, here's Justin Donati. On the right wing side, the quick shot for Tyler Donati, and DeSeres is able to make the stop.
Well, the Donati brothers, they look for each other. They're twins, and they are just nifty. The 31-year-olds, both from Oakville, obviously, and it's always a cross from one side of the ice to the other. Those saucer passes, they played all over in the OHL, the East Coast League, overseas as well.
Rob Heisey wins the draw. Tuzzolino on the left wing. Here's Donati banking it back. Tuzzolino using that long reach. Keeping control here on the Stoney Creek power play. 50 seconds remaining in the man advantage. Trying to tie the game here at 4. Now a stick. Had it broken up. And here's a breakaway. Nolan Hymans in alone. No, it's stopped by Brown. Everybody started to cheer, but Brown said no. And the referee was right in perfect position to make the call.
That is an unbelievable save, just dragging that back foot. That puck looked like it was going over the line for another shorthanded marker, but no.
Hymans will backhand it down, and Brown, who made that stop, will set it up in behind his goal.
David
Brown. His defenders to come back.
The save for Stony Creek.
We've seen some real highlight reel stops tonight. Now a wrist shot from Hewlett. Just missed its mark. Deck rattles it around the side glass. Evans comes out of the penalty box. Here's Lacombe up high. Granbois shot blocked down there. Stony Creek power play now, 2 for 6 with just a pair of shots on goal. So it's been quality and not quantity tonight for Lacombe, led by head coach Sean Robertson tonight. Doug Jesse banks it off the boards, out of the reach of Granbois. Hotham back over to his partner. Rolling puck comes ahead now. Cam Fergus with 2 assists tonight. Can't keep possession of it. Now he will get it back, but he can't put it through the skates. Now in front, he scores! Nathan Pageot! A 4-4 game as Pageot was left all alone in the slot.
These two teams just battling back and forth. A wonderful setup from Matthew Bragg from Newman's Cove, New Brunswick. That's in the left corner. You'll see him come into the screen after Lacombe can't clear. It's a pass in the middle, doesn't make it. There's the pass, it does. And Pageot just rips it into the net and ties things back up at 4. It's a nifty wrist shot past the glove. There's a quick celly to the knees and back up.
First point of the tournament in his 5th year playing with the Stony Creek Generals. Nathan Pageot scores a big goal. Played a couple of years at Bowling Green University. As the puck fluttered high through the air, it's wristed in. Desmond gets it in deep. Off the wall now, played by Hewlett in front of the Lacombe bench. Running in with it now is Rob Heise. On the end wall, held up there by Brad Stepner. Dalrymple gave it away. Karkle shot, just missed low to the glove side. 4:32 the time. Brand new night, don't go anywhere. We could be here a while.
This game has had everything. 5-on-3 goals, shorthanded breakaways, unbelievable goaltending stops from goaltenders in this game. And then the local boy from Stony Creek, that's Nathaniel Pageot, ties the game at 4.
Not a surprise, we're even right now. Round robin play began on Monday. Stony Creek in a 3-3 draw with the host Rosetown Red Wings. Tuesday, Lacombe's first game was a 1-1 draw against the Red Wings again. Keegan McAvoy, the head coach of his Rosetown team, very proud of the effort they put in this week. Here's a chance, scores! Cross ice! A seesaw affair continuing, and Tyler Donati has given the Stony Creek Generals their lead right back.
Don't count out the Donati twins. Capitalizing here in a neutral zone play. Quick strike, saucer, and underneath the goaltender and in.
Second of the tournament for him.
And we've been just oozing about their skill level. And it's Justin Donati to brother Tyler. They've done this at every level they've played together at. And this one puts their team ahead 5-4.
Tozzolino will play it in. Deck with Bragg in behind him. What a wild night here on the prairies. Locals thought they had fun with the Hunter brothers last night at the post-game festivities that were held inside the arena here. Now the puck will find its way all the way in on Jacob Desers, and the Lacombe Generals goaltender will hang on to it. Well, the Stony Creek Generals got themselves in a little bit of a hole in the second period, but all of a sudden here in the third, they've been able to light the lamp twice.
With Holla, Tuck wants the puck, is on the left side, but in, Holla scores! Eric Holla says goodnight!
Chris Cuthbert with the call last night in Vegas. And the story continues for the Golden Knights, right from opening night, joining the National Hockey League. And It really is hockey royalty here in the city of Rosetown. The man in the middle right there, the assistant general manager of the Vegas Golden Knights, Kelly McCrimmon. This is where his family, Dave, got it all started. Their dad, Byron, involved in the early 70s here in senior hockey. That team into the Hockey Hall of Fame here in the province of Saskatchewan. And of course, we've all lost a good friend, Kelly's brother, Brad, a few years ago.
That's the 89 Stanley Cup win for the Calgary Flames. And that's the jacket that's in the foyer here at the AGT Center. Brad McCrimmon, over 1,200 games in the NHL. And boy, what a competitor and well-liked gentleman off the ice as well.
Great man, coach in the Western League when his playing career was over, just an hour away with the Saskatoon Blades. And really, when you're around Rosetown, everybody says, oh yeah, the McCrimmons were here all the time. What a hockey family. Well, we haven't had anything decided just yet. Stoney Creek's got a one goal lead when the teams have combined for nine. And there's what they're playing for.
Yes. Donated in 1909. Sir Montague Allen from Reagan's Crag, Montreal, decided that an amateur trophy should be battled for, and what a battle it's been by the Generals.
Stoney Creek vying for their first title. Lacombe has had the name engraved in their favor three times in 2009, 2013. And as recently 2 years ago in 2016, when we mentioned earlier in the period that Carter Ripley scored the game-winning goal for an overtime victory in Steinbach, Manitoba. David McLennan and I were on hand that night, and the Generals got it done in overtime.
Well, they'll be the host next year for the Allen Cup, as Stoney Creek has iced the puck here. Play just a little bit scrambly. You believe some nerves might be creeping into both sides. Last time the Allen Cup was hosted in Saskatchewan, that was 2012. Lloyd Minster, the Southeast Prairie Thunder, were able to be victorious then.
Face off to the stick side of David Brown. Hobie Baker Award winner back in the 2006-07 season. Evans just missed. He almost lined up Ryan O'Meara on a huge collision. Let it go. Now Bell fires it. And that one went off Brown. I think it hit him in the mask. Evans floats another one just wide of the goal. Bell trying to track it down. On the far side, Blanchard will play it out. And as Evans will skate in after it, he's got Matthew Bragg right behind him, and the North Battleford native will get there first.
Well, we've seen Miles Bell shoot the puck before. It's a quick shot of Matthew Bragg, who was able to set up the tying goal for Stoney Creek. He's a sales consultant at Ellisor, an optical supply company. He's had good eyes in this game with a couple of helpers.
Sure has. Two goals that Stoney Creek scored tonight in a span of a minute and 17 seconds. Conkle will work it down to Hewlett. In behind his goal, Jesse Todd will take the turn here along the left wing side and come out with it now for Velcourt. Velcourt hooked up from behind by Heise. Continuing after the play though is Heisman's. Jesse's going to retreat back here defensively for Lacombe. Puck went over the head of Nathan Deck. Skating in after it now is Chris Hewlett, but that's going to be an icing call here against the Ontario champions.
Stoney Creek's looking to just get the puck up and over the Lacombe defense and then chase onto it, but unfortunately goes down for icing both times. See if Lacombe can find a way to spend more time in the offensive zone. They were there in the first period until penalty trouble got them behind 3-1 after the first.
There's a chance, Desmond fires, missed to the stick side. Saw a little bit of daylight in between the faceoff circles. Gannon with it now, backhand broken up by Donati. Played off the boards by Hotham. Up to the home line, but no further. Battling is Igor Goligoski, 31-year-old out of the Ukraine. Plays it back along the side wall, and Sean Blanchard's going to slow it down now with Bill Marshall watching him. Marshall had to leave the puck. He was offside, and Blanchard will play it for Hotham. Angles it in behind his own net. You almost wonder now if Stoney Creek's going to try and play a little bit of possum at some point here and try and rag off some time, but it might be just a little bit too early for that yet.
You're absolutely correct. They haven't been trying to move the puck up to the forwards by the stick. They're just trying to put things off the boards and out.
O'Mara just missed his man Bragg in front. Taken off the wall and skated here. Big hit as O'Mara had Nowitzki lined up right in front of the penalty box. Now Nowitzki shoots, pad save. Kept in at the line. Here's Stebner, another shot off the glove of Brown. Nowakowski missed his man. And Dalrymple goes back for it here.
It's like the same thing over and over. Lacombe back into their own zone. A couple of regroups like that. And get it right back up and into Stoney Creek's end.
Dalrymple missed Bell. Play will continue on here. It's a one-goal game. It's been quite a night here this evening. Lacombe jumped out to a 1-0 lead. Stoney Creek would score three in a row, including a pair on the power play to take a 3-1 lead, and now they'll try and expand it here. Here's Rob Heise, and he couldn't find his mark towards the goaltender. Now a backdoor feed, and Hewlett had it miss, but there's a penalty coming up. There's going to be a slashing call. Ooh, and then Rob Heise just took a high stick above the waist, and tempers now are starting to flare.
And the officials missed that. And Barteau, the two goal scorer who opened the scoring for Lacombe, is going to sit on that slashing call. Stoney Creek up ice, and that's right on the hands of Heise. What was missed, though, is this contact here at the stick into the chest of Heise. So Lacombe, a little undisciplined here. It cost them in the first period. Can Stoney Creek add to their lead?
That's what Sean Robertson, the head coach, was concerned about coming into the game tonight. Which team would allow themselves to stay more disciplined, stay out of the extracurricular, and not get called. Look out, here comes the puck into the penalty box. And a great catch by one of the off-ice officials.
It's about 7 feet from us. I didn't see you moving.
You were diving. You can come back and stand up here again, Dave.
Yeah, you see the players themselves. That's Barteau thinking.
Yeah. You were a forward, weren't you?
I certainly was. Blocking shots was not my specialty.
Donati battles to keep it in against Jesse, and he will. Blanchard setting up now here on the Stoney Creek power play. Under 10 minutes remaining in the 2018 Allen Cup Championship. Tuzzolini on the left wing side. Blanchard, slap shot, pass save, rebound. They jam away, and Donati can't work it around in front. He's got it in behind the goal, left side pass. Blanchard moves to the midpoint, floats it through, down into the right wing corner again. Here's Tyler Donati around the perimeter to Blanchard. He's got Tuzzolini on the top right point. Top of the left wing circle now. Rob Heise. Heise will walk in. Donati slowing it down on the power play. They will set things up with half the man advantage gone. Jesse battling there. Tuzzolino had it go all the way around over on the far left side. Now it's Bragg in behind the net. Played it off the skated front. Heise has it now, and a diving to Sears is going to get a whistle here with 44 seconds remaining. And the minor penalty right now to Ian Barteau.
It's a smart play by Desers. Puck was clear behind the net, bounced off a stanchion right to the front, but here's the save, the deflection in front. Desers is down, he's trying to find the puck afterwards. You see him get knocked in, he loses stick. And the Donati brothers control again. He doesn't want to go after his stick, gets it back, and then this is where he is knocked. Referee's trying to scramble to get out of the way as well.
Cousins from the midpoint sailed one there. Pad save is made, and Desers was able to get his blocker in front of it. Jesse Todd gets taken down there by Martin Lee. Stoney Creek with two goals here in the third period, just under a minute and a half apart. They've erased a deficit, and they've now got a 5-4 advantage, trying for their first ever Allen Cup victory. Brian Hamm, the head coach, has been in the Allen Cup Championship game as a player or the bench boss 6 times. Has 1 win. Told us before the game he wants a second.
That was back in 2008 with the Brantford Blast.
Hewlett drops it off. Here's Conkle. firing. Stop is made there by Desers.
And he was just thundered to the ice by Barteau.
Deck back in the other way. Put it out in front. Frambois! Grounds down. They jam away. Puck comes free, and there's nobody home to keep it in.
Scramble saved there by Brown. I think that went off the back of his left heel while he was on the ice.
There's a high stick. And a penalty coming up here. Nick Tuzzolino is going to get called. Big power play opportunity coming up. A goal mouth scramble, and Brown's able to keep it out. Well, here's the penalty coming up. And the high stick goes up near the chicklets of Travis Granbois. Nick Tuzzolino doesn't like it. Humble Broncos being recognized here by Hockey Canada. Broncos logo on the boards in front of both benches here tonight. Game one, by the way, in the Saskatchewan Junior Hockey League Championship began at the Centennial Arena in Humboldt tonight. Or in Nipawin, pardon me. And the Estevan Bruins defeat the Hawks by a final score of 3-2. The Bruins take game one in the best of seven SJ Championship on the road to the RBC Cup. 7 minutes remaining in regulation time. Here's the power play for Lacombe. Can they equalize this one tonight?
Well, they haven't got it set up just quite yet. Good speed and pressure by Stoney Creek.
Deck makes the rink wide pass. Todd got it. Belfort backhand missed to the glove side. Dalrymple failed to keep it in. Now Bragg trying to get outside on his man. Matthew Bragg puts down his shoulder, stopped by, and the penalty coming up now as Jacob Desers was able to make the stop. And then Matthew Bragg was ridden hard into that left wing corner.
It was a battle through the neutral zone as Bragg continued his way towards the net. But here's the chance on the entry earlier by Lacombe. And it's right to the middle to Colin Balcour. He misses. The Prince George native can't convert. And then Bragg up ice. Nathan Deck gives him a shot there. Bragg loses his control and slams into the board. So 4-on-4 for minute nine. And then if things stay like this, it'll be a Stoney Creek power play at the tail end.
Nathan Deck, the product of Sedley, Saskatchewan, is a big piece for this Lacombe Hockey Club as well, to be sitting for the next couple of minutes in a one-goal deficit here for head coach Sean Robertson. Fergus, who has three assists tonight, trying to spin it out in front. Now Hewlett angles it back to the line, and Lee looks to get outside here. Nowakowski will run him out of room. Back to the blue line again. Hewlett with some skating room, has it on the right wing side. Lee let it go. Ian Barteau and Brennan Evans are there. And again, Desers will freeze the puck to the left side of his goal. And there's more conversation, a little bit extracurricular, really starting to grow now between these teams.
Hewlett was trying to set up a play from the point, and then it eventually just works its way back to the goaltender. Chris Hewlett from Sault Ste. Marie, Ontario. The mortgage specialist from for RBC if you need some help.
Good to know. Proud sponsors of Hockey Canada and all our great events here. Hymans will play it out. Jesse Todd trying to work in, looking to muscle his way into that right wing corner. Can't. Scott Hoffman pushes him along the perimeter. Tyler Donati in his defensive zone left the puck here. Scott Hoffman will find some room up to center ice. He'll bring it in here. Shot is cleared in. There's 10 seconds remaining in the minor penalty right now. Nick Tuzzolino will be free. And Stoney Creek's going to be on the power play here as Blanchard took his man down right at his own blue line, and now it is an Ontario power play. Stoney Creek 2-for-5 on the night. This is chance number 6 with just over 40 seconds in it. Short-handed though. Lacombe with a short-handed goal already tonight, courtesy of number 97, Jesse Todd. Stebner's pass goes into an open right wing corner. Devin Gannon takes a check from Blanchard. Donati will try and fish it out. Puck comes over here, and Martin Lee will drag it in behind his goal as the clubs are almost back to 5-on-5 play now with the final 10 seconds remaining here in this power play for Stoney Creek. Matthew Bragg in 1-on-3 moves it into the right wing circle down and behind the goal. Fergus waiting. Shot there through the top of the crease goes wide. Deck comes out of the penalty box. Just a single shot on goal in that 40 seconds or so that Stoney Creek was working 5-on-4.
Well, both teams prominent with the penalty kill. First Stoney Creek kills the first part of it, and then Lacombe answers back the second half.
Goaltender David Brown is able to take that puck up high and get a whistle here with over 4 minutes to go.
It's been a great tournament. Fantastic fan support as well here in Rosetown. And everyone's on the edge of their seat to see if Stoney Creek can hold on here. They're ahead on the scoreboard, 5-4 on the shot clock, 34-32.
Thank you to the organizing crew for a spectacular week here in Rosetown, led by Scott Murdoch, the chair, Keegan McAvoy, the head coach. Hundreds of volunteers putting their time and efforts into this to make this 2018 Allen Cup Championship a resounding success. And a great final played here tonight between the Generals of Stoney Creek and Lacombe.
The tournament's been so tight. Talked about those four tie scores in the first six games.
The Donati brothers have figured in big here this evening for Stoney Creek, who have the advantage right now. 3:33 to play, third period. Speaking of everybody to make this thing so successful, Dave, how about the 50-50 tonight? They just announced over $25,000 in a small community like this. That says a lot. Now Donati's got it. This is Justin. Looking for Pajot, who's got a big goal here tonight for Stoney Creek. In behind his net, moved off the sidewall. Lacombe's got to get something going here fairly soon, and Jesse Todd will try his luck along the wall. Played it off the near side, force puck at the goal, and David Brown's going to fall down with bodies all over his crease, and Brown's a little bit slow to get up here.
He got his blocker arm just kind of trapped in the net there. And Lacombe is just trying to put everything into the feet of the goaltender. This is off the base of the net. You see that blocker is stretched around, and the post can't be comfortable just diving into the upper right portion of his body. Time is now becoming an enemy for Lacombe.
Cam Fergus on this defensive zone faceoff. Got it away there from Devin Gannon. Puck comes out. Bragg's in a foot race for it. Bartol will go back. He's got two goals tonight. He's bookended this game here tonight for Lacombe. Had the 1-0 goal and the 4-3 goal. The difference, though, is Stoney Creek has scored the last two. Evans, cross ice, there he is. Bartow's shot didn't get through. O'Mara missed Bragg, and he's going to peel back here on a line change as Lacombe will try and catch Stoney Creek on the switch, but they can't do it. Quick feet there by Jarrett Conkle to get himself on the ice. Tuzzolino will move it all the way down in the Lacombe zone. 2 minutes to go. We'll start to keep an eye on the goaltender here. Does Sean Robertson start to get eye contact here with Jacob Desers?
Stoney Creek believes this should be not icing, complaining it was touched in the neutral zone. There's the coach, Sean Robertson, mulling over what he's going to do with his 6-on-5. Goaltender, though, Desers stays in the net. 2:02 on the clock. You can see that as well.
Sean was a player with this Lacombe franchise when they were involved more with Bentley. Has an Allen Cup ring as a player. Under 2 minutes remaining in this year's Senior Men's Canadian Championship here on TSN. Puck shot in from center ice. In behind his goal, Scott Hobham goes back for it, and there he goes. Desers to the bench. 6-on-5, Lacombe. Hobham off the boards. Unable to keep it in is Nowakowski. Nowakowski makes a quick move. He'll just trickle it off the wall. McCall needs to get somebody in there just a little bit quicker, and Nowakowski is going to have to skate back to his own line again. As Stony Creek's in a pretty good prevent defense right now.
Well, and ring it around the boards too. You get up on the glass, it hits the stanchions, it can go anywhere. They're going to call this icing. Stony Creek believes that it was touched at their own blue line. It'll come back into their zone. Now the key is the faceoff. Try to get your veteran players out there. Tuzzolino has been prominent on defense for Stony Creek.
Up on both benches right now. Everybody is up on their skates.
It's been an intense final, back and forth. Lacombe thought they had everything going their way, opening the score in 45 seconds into this third period, but Stony Creek answers back twice to take the 5-4 lead.
And now Sean Robertson's going to call his timeout and bring the troops in. Well, they went 2-0-1 in the three games they played through round robin and, of course, their semifinal victory. Lacombe knocking off the Hawks by a 4-1 final yesterday. Stony Creek played four games. They went 2-1-1, including their 5-2 win over the Southeast Prairie Thunder.
Lacombe is missing some key players. Their captain, Don Morrison, neck injury in January, surgery. He might be finished playing senior hockey, and as I mentioned, Lacombe is the host next season. Evan Oberg had some NHL time. He's not here. Kyle Bailey, their other captain and top scorer, top centerman, he's not here.
Rob Heisey's got a huge faceoff here. He lost it in the defensive zone. Can Lacombe keep it in? No, they can't. Ryan O'Meara in front of his teammates will get it up to the Lacombe blue line. And now Ian Marteau gave it away at center ice. Heisey to the empty net. He scores! Rob Heisey! And the Stony Creek Generals bomb on their bench. They've got a 6-4 lead with under a minute to play.
And there's a reason we talked about him in the opener. Heisey knows offense. Had some nice plays in this tournament, but none finer than finding the empty net to put Stony Creek up 6-4. Under a minute left to play, and the celebration says it all. First-time finalists, they might be first-time winners if they can keep Lacombe under the final minute here from coming back.
Well, speaking of first, he had the assist on the goal by Justin Donati, which tied the game at one after the early goal by Ian Marteau. So he's got an assist, and now he's got a big empty netter. And Jacob Desers is going to go right back to the bench. Shot from the left wing side, missed there off the stick of Igor Gongolski. What a week it's been, Rosetown. Thanks for the hospitality. And as the clock starts to wind down, the Stony Creek Generals, under the guidance of head coach Brian Hamm, in their first appearance, are all standing up and getting ready to have some fun tonight here on the prairies.
Well, it's the heart of the wheat belt. It might be the heart of hops and barley this evening. As Stony Creek had to battle their way through. They didn't get the extra day off. This is their fourth game in four nights, and they're under 20 seconds away from celebrating.
Heisey that scored that empty netter will take the faceoff here against Travis Granbois. Puck goes into the corner, lifted high through the air all the way down. This will be an icing call again. No touch icing in this event.
That conversation we had with the coach of the Stony Creek Generals, Brian Hamm, he mentioned he'd won it, but he'd lost it more than he'd like. Won it as a player.
Quick shot happens. Off the faceoff, didn't get through. Now the bouncing puck comes towards Brown. They'll just jam away at him. And as Brown is underneath the pile of players, he's got Velcourt upset. He lost his helmet, he had lost his balance, fell in on the goaltender, and a couple of the Stony Creek players took exception. 35-33 now, Stony Creek out shooting Lacombe. And the officials are able to keep a lid on this here.
A frustration by Lacombe. 45 seconds into that third period. They take the lead.
Bob Heisey getting congratulated by his teammates over on the bench. They'll bring the faceoff outside the blue line. Colin Belcourt's got to get off the ice. He lost his helmet.
They're going to send the players over to the penalty box, but he thought he was sent to the showers.
So he'll make his way down. Sean Blanchard will make his way into the penalty box. The captain will get out in 8 seconds' time. As Stoney Creek won the faceoff, and that'll do it as another puck goes into the empty net. It'll be a 7-4 game with 4.6 remaining.
Well, this Stoney Creek team has battled all the way through this tournament in a battle here in the third.
That's a great shot from long distance.
It certainly is. Player hasn't really got a lot of ice time in this game, Sawyer. That's Justin Sawyer, the 32-year-old from Oshawa, Ontario. Finds the cage.
Ryan O'Mara and Jesse Todd will line in for the final faceoff of the 2018 Allen Cup here tonight in Rosetown. And that'll do it here tonight. For the first time in franchise history, congratulations to the Stoney Creek Generals. They've won the Allen Cup here in the heart of Saskatchewan.
3 years in a row, they've won the Robertson Cup. But they've upped the ante, and they did it through special teams and some special plays. Goaltending, solid by David Brown. But it's that third period, the comeback by Stoney Creek, that seals the deal for them. First time winners, and they're gonna enjoy it.
David Brown played every minute for the Stoney Creek Generals in goal this week. In his second year, he was absolutely sensational here. 30 saves tonight for number 30, and a national championship for the Ontario representatives. Congratulations to Brian Hammond Company. We'll have the trophy presentations next here from the Allen Cup.
The 2018 Allen Cup from Rosetown, Saskatchewan is brought to you by Esso. The Esso brand has fueled Canada's love of hockey for over 30 years. By Nike, official gear of Canada's national hockey team. By RBC, let's make Sunday happen. And by TELUS, powering the network that keeps us all connected.
As we welcome you back inside the AGT Center here tonight in Rosetown, Saskatchewan, for the final time and for the first time, the Stoney Creek Generals are celebrating an Allen Cup championship. And Dave, they've got the trophy ready, and this is what these players have been waiting for since Monday when they started round-robin competition.
And it was a bumpy start to the tournament, a tie to the host team, the Rosetown Red Wings, and then a loss to these Lacombe Generals. But then they ramped things up, made it past Bethune, beat the Southeast Prairie Thunder to get themselves here in this championship game. And what a gutsy effort. Had the lead, relinquished it, and then found a way in the third.
Quite a game here tonight, no question about it. A 3-1 lead after the opening period, despite the fact that Ian Barteau had the game's opening goal. Looked like special teams were going to be a very big part in tonight's game. They were, as by the end of the game, we see three power play goals and a shorthanded goal combined between Stoney Creek and Lacombe.
Well, normally when you give up a power play goal and a shorthanded goal against, that's what happened to Stoney Creek. It kind of guts you a little bit, but Stoney Creek just banded together in the third. And talking with their coach, he just says it's a special group of guys. They play hard for each other. And roster decisions, having guys come in and out of the lineup, they all support one another. And now they can leave this building heads held high and champions of the Allen Cup.
Well, there they are. The wily veteran gets to raise it for the first time. The captain, Sean Blanchard. One of the seven goal scorers here tonight for Stoney Creek. And they will have some fun, the Ontario representatives. able to enjoy it here tonight in Rosetown. We're an hour outside of Saskatoon, a couple of hours away from Humboldt. And here this evening, David Brown, Sean Blanchard, and a number of veteran players will take a victory lap here tonight and enjoy what they have been able to work for and complete going through this week, Dave, with a 3-1-1 record in the five games.
What impressed me the most by this team, they've got that combination you look for. Skill with Heisey, Donati brothers, some solid defense, a fantastic goaltender, and they play for one another, and they're able to call themselves the best in amateur hockey across all of Canada here in Rosetown.
Well, it's been a great week. Thanks again to all the organizers that have made this thing possible, starting with the chair, the organizing committee, the fans, everybody that has welcomed these six teams into Rosetown. And here tonight, the Stoney Creek Generals will celebrate as this night continues. Justin Sawyer and his teammates will take the victory lap here tonight. 7-4 is the final. On behalf of our color analyst tonight, Dave Tomlinson, our entire TSN team that is gathered here tonight in Rosetown, this is Brian Munns. Thank you for joining us. A wild, wild night won by Stoney Creek. 7-4 the final. Stoney Creek Generals, for the first time, are Allen Cup champions.